Now that you've got Pro Tools SE installed on your computer and your audio interface is connected, let's take a look at the Quick Start menu. The Quick Start menu appears once Pro Tools SE has launched, and it looks like this. At the top of the Quick Start are four tabs: New Session, Demo Songs, Open Session, and Tutorials. If you wanted to record an original composition from scratch, you'd choose a new session and then select a starting template from the list. There's a guitar template that has three different guitar sounds ready to go. There's a keyboard-based template, a template for loop-based composition, and a vocal template consisting of a male and a female vocal. The session's key signature is C major, tempo is 120 beats per minute, and the time signature is 4/4. Now, once you choose it, you'll be prompted to name your session and save it to a location on your hard drive. Once a name has been given, press Enter or Return to save the session. Now, once the edit window appears, you can start recording on any of the two tracks that are available to you. There's the male vocal track, and this one is set up for the female. Just record enable any one of those tracks and you're ready to record. Check 1, 2, testing 1, 2. That track's got a little bit of reverb on it, whereas the second track, testing 1, 2, check 1, 2, has less verb and a different EQ. Nice. I'm gonna go to the file menu, close this session, and you can choose to save it or not. But either way, you'll be returned to the Quick Start menu. Nice. The second tab, Demo Songs, is a great place for you to explore if you're somewhat unfamiliar with recording or mixing in Pro Tools SE. There's a variety of genres for you to choose from. Each demo song allows you to audition the session before you load it. Now, if for some reason you can't hear the music when you hit play, then just go to your system preferences to the sound control panel and double check that your output is not set to internal speakers or the line out. You want to make sure that the audio interface that came with Pro Tools SE is selected for system sound output. Now when you hit preview, you should hear the demo song. That's the blues one. And let's take a listen to Rock, number 3, because that's got a vocal in it. And once you find a demo that you like, come down and hit the choose button and the demo song will load. Now, once it opens, just come up to the top of the edit window and click the play button to begin playback. You can see the counters reading off the bar and beat position of the song. Now, the space bar will toggle between stop and play depending on where you click in the edit window. Take a trip to the docks. If you click and drag to make a selection and then hit spacebar, playback will begin at the beginning of the selection and stop at the end of the selection, which is nice. Kaleidoscope angel wants to trip with. Now, once you've finished exploring the demo song, just come up to the file menu and choose close, and you'll be returned to the Quick Start menu. The next tab, Open Session, simply keeps a running list of all of the sessions that you've been working on. You can see both the rock demo and the vocal session that we saved earlier. This is a great way to get back to the session quickly and easily without having to navigate your hard drive. The last tab is the Tutorial tab. You can learn about setup, playback, recording, or arranging. Each page has movies and text, so you can learn as you go along. Here's the mixing page. There's the movie and there's the text. There's plenty of information on each page, so be sure that you scroll down. That way, you're not going to miss anything. On the right-hand side are some interactive projects, such as recording a vocal, creating a podcast, or how to make a mix. With Pro Tools SE, you're only a few clicks away from the help that you need. All that's left for you to do is open up one of your sessions and start making music right now. Fantastic.